Hey, I'm Jim Cunneen, and what we're gonna do today is something a little untraditional. Basically, it's container gardening for people with small spaces, and we're gonna use this plastic tub, which is gonna be ideal for all kinds of different vegetables. But step one, we're gonna do, drill some holes in the bottom for drainage. Well, the main reason we're drilling these holes is so we wind up not having water sit in the bottom of the container, and that's never a good thing. It won't dry up fast enough, and it's really not good for the roots of your plant material. Okay, there's our holes. I figure that's probably plenty. We don't want too many because we don't want the soil to run out all over the place. So next step, we'll be filling this with a high quality potting mix. All right, so what we're gonna do is fill this up almost to the top, settle it in there. And this is a 10-gallon container. So we've got almost a bag of soil in here. I'm gonna spread that out a little bit. We're almost there. A little bit more. I think that should be about enough. I'm gonna compact it just a little bit so it, when it does get watered down, it doesn't wind up dropping a whole lot. So we'll just press it down a little bit. We don't want it too compact because that's never good for anything. We've got our soil in place. Now we're gonna start planting. What we've got here now are small onion sets. Basically, one onion set equals one onion when it grows up. So we're gonna put those in. Just put your finger in the ground, dig it down about an inch. Just carefully position the soil around it. We wanna do 3-4 inches apart. And we just keep on going down the line like that. So we're gonna have 8 in here just because of our size constraint. And there we go with that. That'll be good, good, good. Be kind of a surprise what kind of an onion it is. Okay, well, that's the last one planted. So now we wanna talk about how we're gonna water this guy. Basically, right now, we're gonna wanna thoroughly water it, get the whole thing good and wet, and then every week or a few days, you can just stick your finger in. If you go down about 1.5 inches and you come back with a dry finger, it's time to add a little bit more water. And you can adjust that as need be. The nice thing about this being portable, you can have it on your balcony and say the sun's coming in from one side and they all start growing up that way. You can spin this guy around, you can move it wherever you want to. Say it's getting too much sun, push it back into a corner. That could be also cool. It's gonna be a fun project and you guys can have some fun doing it. All right, well, I'm gonna move on to this next one, which is another easy project to do. Okay, well, I'm back with a whole nother side of the project. These grow bags. These things are gonna be awesome for what we're gonna plant here today, the potatoes. So what we're gonna wanna use is this bigger one, which is a 15-gallon. It's very nice because it does have a lot of drainage just right through the material itself and good aeration. And it's also portable. Well, step one, we're gonna fill the bag with quality potting mix. Well, the bag is partially full. With these potatoes that we're gonna be planting today, we wanna plant them 4 to 5 inches deep. So what I'm gonna do is leave the 4 to 5 inches out for right now and put the potatoes in. This is what we're gonna be using today. It's a very small red potato that we're gonna need to cut it in half. There's our half cuts. So what we're gonna do with those is plant those, cut side down, eyes up, giving them enough room apart from each other so that they got plenty of room to grow. What we're gonna wind up doing now is put in the rest of the soil. We're gonna wanna leave the soil about 3 inches from the top of the bag. That's got the potato project all wrapped up. There's other things you can do too. Basically, any kind of seed you want to do can go in here or into plastic bins, and we can also do transplants. So what I'm going to do is find a good place for this and give it a drink of water. Okay, there we have it, our mini farm. We've got all kinds of things, strawberries, tomatoes, eggplant, basil, rosemary, potatoes, and onions. So keep in mind that we're gonna wanna feed this after about a month. So we wanna use a quality plant food every 7 to 14 days. I'm Jim Cunneen, and let's get out and play in the dirt.